Good day, everyone, and welcome to my crypto paradise. This is Nathan, and today we will be looking at Cardano. Yes, the top six cryptocurrency, which currently have the total capitalization of nearly $10 billion. This is pretty strong. What we see is the price is in red right now, so declining slightly. But let's have a look at the charts, especially the daily time frame for the Cardano against the Bitcoin, because it could be more interesting for the people to see prices against the Bitcoin rather than the dollar. So let's see whether the Cardano can outperform the Bitcoin or the Bitcoin will continue to dominate the cryptocurrency market. Now, this is a daily time frame, and first, what we can spot is the huge trading volume, which we had just last week. There was a really, really big buying pressure on the Cardano. Although we have descending channel, and as can be seen, price failed to break above the channel. Now, another interesting and important thing is that there is a massive resistance formed near 1,000 satoshis, which also has been rejected multiple times. This makes the area between 1000 and potentially 1100 satoshis an extremely strong resistance. In order for the long-term trend to begin or start, we definitely need to have the break above this resistance area. Now, the most recent price action shows that we had reached the support at 710 satoshis. Another important thing is that there was no break below the moving average. This is the 50 simple moving average and no breakout. We can see there were spikes, although it failed. At the same time, previous level of resistance became the area of support, also rejected. And this huge buying volume implies that buyers might be starting to take the control. It seems like this support is now very, very important. And as long as daily closing price will remain above 710 satoshis, it's most likely that the price will continue rising. Now, the nearest resistance obviously is one of these levels. First is near 980 satoshis, and second could be the 50% FIPS at 10,048 satoshis. Perhaps price will be spiking above, but we need definitely to have a clear break and close above this area on the daily time frame for the Cardano to establish the uptrend. Now let's see the lower time frame, for example, 1 hour time frame. On this chart, what we can see is the price moving within the ascending channel. Recently, there was a rejection of the 50 simple moving average and price remains above the 200 simple moving average. This is the validity of an uptrend. Higher highs and higher lows are being printed. Nonetheless, it is possible that this is an ABC correction, after which price will have a sharp decline to the downside. But all in all, price remains bullish, and it's very important that the previously made high has been broken, which could be now acting as the area of support and potential demand zone, especially considering that the price is approaching the moving average and the middle of the ascending channel. So maybe there won't be any immediate move right now from the Cardano, although we might be seeing some correction towards the bottom of the channel. Maybe after that, price will start rising. But the most important factor is, as long as this slow holds, this is a bullish trend for Cardano. Obviously, if that will change, daily close below will clearly invalidate bullish outlook, and more likely price will either range or move towards the 583 satoshis support. Now, this is the support area that has been established previously since November 2020, and this is very important support zone which might be retested in case price will go down. But at the moment, it certainly looks like there is a probability for this uptrend continuation. Nonetheless, we must be cautious about this support area. Now, let's have a look at ADA versus the USDT. Now, this is a 4 hour time frame. You can see it at the top left corner, and we might be having completed an A, B, and C correction, which means that the trend is about to continue. This obviously makes this low produced recently at $0.22 a very strong support and the potentially the key support or support area, because we might be retesting this area in the worst case scenario as long as the uptrend is valid. At this moment, there are no signs that there is a downtrend or there is a trend reversal, especially considering that the price remains above the 200 simple moving average. It remains above 50 simple moving average. And as we can see, there was a break to the upside, then moving average got rejected. So clearly this low, the local support, also important, but on the lower time frames, because break below the support on the 4-hour and or daily time frame will send the price lower with a high probability. And in this case, we might be retesting the support area, and only then price will slowly start to move up. At this point, this is the bullish trend in regards to the potential resistance. Well, if we look at the daily time frame, we have applied FIBs to this last or previous strong corrective move to the downside. As can be seen, there are several levels, important levels. 161.8 is the closest support in case of the break below the 0.26 support. But now we have also 261.8 FIBs, which also corresponds to 38.2 FIBs. Moving back to forward time frame, and what we can see, this support got rejected. Yet again, very important support. Yet again, confirming that this is a bullish trend. This is very important. And as long as we hold this low, it will remain bullish. So there are two Fibonacci levels, support levels, confirming the validity of an uptrend. Back to the daily time frame. What can be seen is that the nearest resistance could be at 361.8 FIBs, or if broken, we might be going further up towards 461.8 FIBs at 0.44 cents. So there are two resistance levels to be watched, 0.36 and 0.44. Maybe if there will be breakout, price will skyrocket. Who knows? We don't. But we need to watch the price action and then act accordingly. In regards to the trading volume, as can be seen, there was really high trading volume at this candle, although then price corrected down. Volume started to decrease, and for this reason, maybe it will also important to watch the trading volume or increasing the trading volume on the 1-hour chart. If we see something above average, like at this case, this could be the entry point, for example, because we can see the strong selling pressure, and this is exactly when the price reverses. Same we had on the daily time frame, really strong buying pressure, and then this is where the price corrects down. So upon some sort of huge selling volume, there could be an opportunity, but only as long as this support holds. For now, we can see there is a potential for an upside move. Price broke above the trend line. This is the area which should be watched. This is the demand area. And if there will be a correction, it could provide a very, very good risk to reward ratio. And just a quick look at the Bitcoin. Well, this is what is happening. We had a clean rejection of the support, previous resistance, as well as the uptrend trend line. This is the average price uptrend trend line got rejected cleanly. This makes the support very important. And for now, we have the resistance at the moving average. This is possible that we might be seeing a consolidation phase for 3-4 days before and if uptrend continues. But for now, seems like there is a resistance at $42,000 and the support at $30,000. And there could be this consolidation ongoing. We need to see some sort of breakout in order to confirm further uptrend or a further correctional move to the downside. And back to our previously made analysis for the chain link. So here we expected the move to the upside. This could be quite a nice move. And overall, we can see the break above this resistance today. So if there will be a confirmed breakout, which on 1-hour chart already confirmed, 4-hour candle hasn't closed yet daily as well. And if we have a daily close above this, could be that the buyers will start stepping in and sending price higher. It looks pretty bullish. Nothing has changed. The price remains above 200 moving average, which recently got rejected. A new higher high is being printed. And link against the Bitcoin, we can see price is within the range. There was an attempt to break above the range, yet it failed. So we're still waiting to see the break to the upside. If there will be the breakout, then the resistance becomes yet again 38.2 FIPS and the moving average. Probably there will be a break to the upside, consolidation for some time, and only then we might continue going up. But this is only as long as the support at 61.8 FIPS will hold. This is 40,000 Satoshis area, support area. If not, we might be expecting the decline fast drop yet again towards 34,000, 35,000 Satoshis, maybe even lower. So very important to watch what will be happening to this range zone. So that's it on Cardano. We hope you enjoyed it. This was Nathan from My Crypto Paradise, and we wish you a profitable trading.